like you are ready, click here to start streaming. Okay. अच्छा मी आता प्रेझेंट करणार माझ्या ह्याच्यावर हे मी पूर्ण ह्या स्क्रीनवरच जातो बरं मोठे नाही अजून तुला बोलाय झालोच नाही ना त्याच्यामुळे मी बी बसू जा की देखून एक मिनिट लागत देत ना ठीक आहे ना आय विल जस्ट कीप इट Good morning students. Let's start our today's topic. My name is Pankaj Ghodke and today we are going to see fiber optic technology, most important unit from our syllabus. Let's start with our today's session. Fiber technology. Let's start with our India. Good morning students. Today we are going to learn very interesting and important topic from our syllabus, that is fiber technology. Let's move ahead. First we'll see the condition of India, especially the telecom operators. Right now 3 to 4 major telecom operators present in India. We'll see the statistics related to their shares in entire telecom industry in India. All these data has been taken from Telephone Regulatory Authority of India. That is TRAI. You have heard this word, especially in the news, while delivering different plans through TRAI. So majorly we do have 4 to 5 different telecom operators. One of the telecom operator is Reliance Jio, then Airtel, newly launched or renamed as a Vodafone India, that is Vodafone Idea, then BSNL, and one of the company that is related to Reliance, that was Arcom. Maybe possible few of students know this Arcom, Reliance Communication, and MTNL. So we'll see that out of 125 crore Bharatiyon ke beech mein, how many people use which telecom operator for the communication. We'll see one by one the statistics of these telecom providers. So Jio consumers, out of the entire Indian population, 36% of the telephone users use Reliance Jio. The second operator is Airtel. About 30% of telecom users use Airtel as their telephone operator. And then it's number of Vodafone Idea. About 24% of market share belongs to Vodafone Idea. 10% belongs to BSNL. And can you guess what will be the share of this Arcom? This Arcom is nothing but Reliance Communication, which was once upon a time the subsidiary company of this Reliance. Arcom was the first company who gave the cheaper mobile and cheap call rate in India. That company was the first one to provide mobile communication, and in the hand of entire India, Arcom provide the mobile, which was the dream of Dhirubhai Ambani. So now the condition of that Arcom is very bad nowadays. So Arcom has now 0.001%. Very small amount of users still use Arcom, and 0.28% people use MTNL, Mahanagar Telephone Nigam Limited. We'll proceed further after watching the statistics. Let's start with our formal communication, that is formal lecture. Welcome to Maharashtra Institute of Technology, Aurangabad, approved by AICT, NAC Grade A, and affiliated permanently with Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar Marathwada University, Aurangabad. This is your first year BTech course, and our course name is Engineering Physics. About myself, I am Pankaj Ghodke, Assistant Professor, Basic Sciences and Humanities Department. Today's outline for presentation, the flow for the presentation will be like this. First, we'll see introduction to communication system. Then we'll see propagation of light through optical fiber or fiber optic cable. Then basic terms related to fiber optics, types of fiber optics, applications of fiber optics. Then we'll see what is holography and its applications. After India, let's have a world tour. That's the reason why I have keep the map of the entire world in front of you. So sit back, tighten your seat belt, and let's fly to various continents in our today's session. One by one, we'll go to all the continents and we'll see the entire world. After India, we'll go to the remaining part of our Asia. Let's go to Asian continent. So it is said that without history, your future will be very difficult. So it is very important to know history as well as to create your future. So we'll go through some historical part. So we know Sir Alexander Graham Bell was the first person who have filed a patent for telephone as an apparatus for transmitting vocal or other sounds telegraphically. Do you know? This was the story on internet, that was a message spread through other social media like WhatsApp and YouTube and other things, that why we say hello. So it was said, it was believed that Margaret Hello was the person who was related, or you can say she was the girlfriend of Sir Alexander Graham Bell, but it's not true. So it is said that when there was a first call made by Sir Alexander Graham Bell, then he said, "Hello, come here." But it is not true. When I search on the internet and various other things, at that time I came to know that Sir Thomas Edison, who invented the electric bulb, he was the person who have introduced the very popular word hello. While answering the telephone calls, we use hello. That word was given by Sir Thomson, not by Sir Alexander Graham Bell. I will tell you the first sentence that was said on telephone was, "Hello, Mr. Thomson, come here. I want to see you." That was the first word. Thomson was the colleague of Sir Alexander Graham Bell. That was the first word said by Sir Bell. We'll see some more things related to Sir Graham Bell. So he was the great personality. Just because of him, we can now able to talk to other person without any kind of efforts. Even though we are thousands of miles away from your near and dear one, still we can make a call, we can send a voice call, or we can chat, or we can have a video call through our newly invented device. But the foundation of that communication was led by Sir Alexander Graham Bell. So he was the person. And this was the photograph which was taken at the time of his demonstration, when he used that telephone for the first time. He have called all his friends and all his colleagues, scientist friends, to show his invention to the entire world. And this was the device. This was the device through which he have made a first call. And on the other side, same kind of device was there. Here it was a mouthpiece, and on the right hand there was earphone. So he called from this device. The entire table is occupied by that entire phone, that was the bulky one. And from the other room, he called his colleague that, "Mr. Thomson, please do come here. I want to see you." That was the first sentence from Sir Alexander Graham Bell that was talk on telephone. So we'll see the development of phones after Sir Alexander Graham Bell. We'll see how phone get developed. So development was phone was carried out in this fashion. See, in 1876 there was a bulky kind of instrument through which we have to hold one of the instrument mouthpiece by one hand, and with the other hand we used to listen to others sound. So many scientists and engineers have performed thousands of experiments, and they tried to convert this bulky instrument into a very small apparatus. In 1880s, we get such kind of instruments. After that, a push button telephone was introduced, but that was wired in 1960s. And in 1980s, we get a wireless communication, that is with a bulky kind of phone. And in the year 2000, we have been introduced by the small cell phones. So this was the telephones that was launched during the year 2000-2001. In 2007, a revolution began, and the great company like Apple has put their foot in the telecom industry, and they launched the first Apple iPhone. First generation Apple iPhone was launched in 2007. And in 2010, Samsung have given a kind of competition to Apple, and now we can able to see what kind of rivalry is being there in various mobile or manufacturer of mobile. There everybody is trying to have a race in mobile development. Okay, we'll talk about call tariff now. Before moving towards fiber optic communication, we'll see call tariff, what was the condition few years back. So mobile call, phone call history. 15 years back, the first cellular call was made. 15 saal pehle, pehla phone call kiya gaya tha on the 31st July. same month, 31st July 1995, and today we have about 635 million mobile subscribers just in India. हमारे इंडिया में पहला कॉल किया गया था 31st July 1995 को. Then of course, at that time, Nokia was the world leader. Nokia, of course, is celebrating its 15th year of presence in India. And so, in Indian telecom revolution. In early days, you know, there were only 5 billion subscribers. That means only 50 lakh people use mobile communication for the first 6 years. Means from 1995 to 2001, there were only 50 lakh people used to have that mobile. And do you know what was the tariff, call tariff for that period? At that time, in the year of 1995 to 2000, this last 5 years, there was a call charge of rupees 16 for per minute. You have been charged for rupees 16 per minute. You are very fortunate enough that you are enjoying the freedom to make a call or receive a call almost about free of cost. But you know, there was a period in 1995 to 2000 or 2005, there was a period where the telecom users has been charged for incoming calls also. So after 2001 or 2005, the incoming calls has been made free of cost to reduce the rivalry. आपस की दुश्मनी कम करने के लिए उन्होंने इनकमिंग कॉल्स ख़त्म कर दिया. एंड टू प्रमोट मोर एंड मोर मोबाइल यूजर्स इन इंडिया, ट्राई हैव इंट्रोड्यूस द न्यू पॉलिसी टू हैव अ फ्री इनकमिंग कॉल. द चार्ज फॉर ओनली आउटगोइंग कॉल हैज़ बीन देयर. आफ्टर दैट वील मूव अहेड टू नेक्स्ट कॉन्टिनेंट. आफ्टर एशिया, लेट्स गो टू USA. लेट्स सी हाउ fiber optic and how it is related to laser or light. So traditionally the communication was done with the help of copper wire. A few years back, before 20 to 30 years, communication was done through a landline phone, and that landline phone runs on this copper wire. Nowadays it has been replaced by fiber optic cable. Whenever I used to see this copper wire communication, at that time there was one person that appeared in my mind, and how he used to make a prank or how he used to make a comedy out of that copper wire communication that appears in my mind. So maybe possible you have heard this, you have heard such kind of calls, or before 20 years such kind of things can be possible. So he was the person, you know, his name is Johnny Lever, and this scene has been taken from a movie called Dule Raja. So traditionally the communication was done with the help of copper wire, but the problem with that copper wire communication, that anybody can apply two different cables to that copper wire and he can able to listen to your calls, or he can make a call in your absence, even though your phone is off at your home, but by this pole anybody can make a call. So that was the kind of disadvantage of this copper wire, and it is very difficult to maintain the copper wire. The cost of copper wire and its installation and its maintenance was huge enough, and that's the reason why nowadays copper wire communication is not being in use. Now that copper wire is being replaced by fiber optic cable. Now we'll see how that revolution and how that fiber optic cable is being used by various methods. So for that we need to go through some basic terms. The difference between two systems is that fiber optic communication uses light pulses for the transmission of information, that is voice signals, instead of electronic pulses which was used in copper wire system, and we have discussed few minutes back. So how this light or laser light has been transmitted from one end to other end, let's see. Here laser light or LED light is used for the generating the light pulses. Using different angles and lens system, that light pulses are transmitted into fiber optic system. So maybe possible you have seen this kind of image or a kind of showpiece in your home. So these are the plastic fibers through which a light can propagate from one end to other end, and on the other end you will be able to see such kind of bright spots. So this is nothing but fiber optic cable. This fiber optic cable may be of size of your hair, human hair. It is very thin. Okay, let's move ahead for fiber optic. So metal cable transmits signals in the form of electric current because it is made up of copper wire, copper cable, whereas fiber optic is made up of glass or plastic and it transmits signals in the form of light or light pulses, either through laser light or some LED light. And we know the light is made up of electromagnetic wave and its velocity is about 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So we do have a huge velocity to transmit our signal from one end to other end. The speed of light depends on the density of a medium through which it is traveling. That means if the density is more, then the velocity of light will decrease slightly. If density is less, then in that case light will travel with this velocity of 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Okay, then we'll see nature of light. How light is there? Light travels in a straight line, we know, as long as it is moving through a single uniform substance. That means if light is moving in air, then it will be moving in a straight line only. If the light is moving underwater, it will be moving in a straight line underwater only. If a ray is traveling through one substance, suddenly enters into another, less or more dense medium, its speed changes abruptly, causing the ray to change direction. This change in the path is called refraction. Now we have studied reflection and refraction. We'll have a quick revision regarding reflection and refraction. What does it say? It says when light travel from one medium to another medium, so that second medium may be less dense or more dense. Depending on the change in medium, light changes its path or its velocity gets slightly changes. So that can be seen with the help of the phenomena that is refraction. See, the upper medium, so the upper medium is air and the lower medium is water or glass. So when light is traveling in this way, so this is incident beam, this is normal and this is angle of incidence I. If light beam is traveling in this way, whenever there is a change in medium, see, light is entering from air medium to water medium or glass medium, it is expected that light should travel in a straight line, but due to change in refractive index or density, light get bent towards normal and it is bending and moving ahead in this way, and this angle is called as angle of reflection. Whereas the same condition but in a reverse order, when light is traveling in a more dense medium, see, this is more dense medium, water or glass, so light is moving in this way, it is making angle of incidence I with the normal. So it is expected that when it is coming out of the water, it is moving in this direction, but instead of that it is getting bent away from normal. Normal se dur bend hoti hai, and this is called as angle of refraction. This angle of refraction increases. Why? Because light is moving from more dense medium to less dense medium. So this is related to refraction. Let's move to next part. So after USA, let's go to UK, United Kingdom. So we'll see reflection now. So what is reflection? When light is fall on any surface, or that may be a kind of reflecting surface or non-reflecting surface, when light rays bounce back with the same angle, then that phenomena is called as reflection. Now see, this is a kind of one layer, and when light is incident on this, it is getting reflected. So this is a kind of mirror. So light get reflect in this way. If you plot a normal, then the angle of incidence and angle of reflection is the same. So this phenomena is called as reflection. Okay, let's see refraction. Now let's go for refraction. We have seen refraction when light is traveling from one medium and entering into another medium, more dense medium, it get bent towards normal. This is called angle of deviation. It is expected light should move in this way, but it is getting bent, and this angle is called as angle of reflection. Now we'll move towards critical angle. If the angle of incidence is increased, so does the angle of refraction. Agar angle of incidence agar badhaya jaye to angle of refraction bhi change hoga. The critical angle is defined as the angle of incidence above which total internal reflection occur. Kya hoga? Total internal reflection. So try to remember this word, because we are going to use this word for our next 15 to 20 minutes. So total internal reflection, how this total internal reflection occur, that we'll see. See, you do have this four different diagrams. So this is one medium. When light is traveling in this way, that is very small angle with a normal, it is get deviated slightly. So angle of refraction is slightly more. In second diagram, if angle of incidence is increased slightly, then similar way angle of refraction also get increased. Now see, angle of refraction, it is deviated more. If I still increase the angle of incidence, still angle of refraction get increased. And one time will come when I send light wave in this specific angle, the angle of refraction will be along the axis of that material. Ye do jo jahan par milte hain, this less dense medium and more dense medium, the light will travel along the boundary. So this angle, this specific angle is called as critical angle. We'll see critical angle in next slide also, critical angle in detail. So what is critical angle? We'll see through these three different images. See, angle of incidence is less than critical angle of refraction. So in that case, light just go away, bend and move out of this medium. If angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, then the light will travel along the axis of these two different medium. That will light will remain into that medium. But when angle of incidence I, that is greater than critical angle of reflection, so in that case, now see, angle of incidence is increased now. So in that case, the light will be reflected from this boundary. Even though there is air and water, light will reflect from the inner side of this water boundary and get reflect back. So this is called as critical angle. So this angle I is called as critical angle. My point, this is related to critical angle. Let's go for next part. After UK, let's go for Africa. Let's start fiber optic cable, the construction, how the fiber optic cable is made up of. Fiber optic cable is basically made up of three major parts. So first, the innermost part is called as core. The outer part, the next part beside that core, is called as cladding. And on the cladding, there is a plastic sheath, there is a kind of plastic cover that is called as coating or buffer jacket. And this is the additional part. So these are the nothing but copper wires which provide strength to this delicate cable. So this core and cladding, this is made up of small plastic, or sometimes it is made up of silica or glass. Those are delicate ones. So to provide a mechanical strength, we used to provide a sheathing fiber, that is, it is made up of metals, and at the outermost part, that is a cable jacket, which is made up of plastic, so that water and other things cannot go and disturb the core and cladding. Okay, so this is the construction for fiber optic cable. Let's see the 3D diagram. See, this is inner part. This is just like a small tube, small hollow tube. अंदर से कुछ नहीं होता. दिस इज जस्ट लाइक अ पाइप, स्मॉल पाइप. द थिकनेस ऑफ दैट पाइप मे बी ऑफ द थिकनेस ऑफ योर हेयर, ह्यूमन हेयर. एंड अबोव दैट कोर देर इज अ क्लैडिंग, देर इज अ क्लैडिंग. द आउटर मोस्ट पार्ट इज कॉल्ड क्लैडिंग, एंड ऑन दैट क्लैडिंग देर इज अ बफर कोटिंग और जैकेट. ओके, देन वी सी डिफरेंट मटेरियल फॉर फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल्स. नाउ बाय विच मटेरियल दिस फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल इज मेड अप ऑफ. द इनर मोस्ट पार्ट, सी दिस कोर, दिस इनर मोस्ट पार्ट कोर इज मेड अप ऑफ सिलिका. वी नो ग्लास, मेजोरिटी ऑफ ग्लास इज मेड अप ऑफ सिलिका. सो कोर इज मेड अप ऑफ सिलिका और प्लास्टिक. द क्लैडिंग, द नेक्स्ट पार्ट दैट इज क्लैडिंग, इज मेड अप ऑफ अ पॉलीमर, और इट इज ऑल्सो अ काइंड ऑफ सिलिका ग्लास. बट द ओनली डिफरेंस इज दैट द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ दिस कोर इज मोर. सी दिस बोथ मटीरियल, कोर एंड क्लैडिंग, कैन बी मेड बाई ग्लास और प्लास्टिक, बट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दिस टू थिंग्स इज दैट रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ कोर इज मोर दैन दैट ऑफ क्लैडिंग. कोर का रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ज़्यादा होना चाहिए, देन एंड ओनली देन इट विल हेल्प अस फॉर टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. है ना, आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. रिमेंबर दैट टर्म, टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. सो जस्ट ट्राई टू रिमेंबर, द इनर मोस्ट पार्ट दैट इज कोर इज हैविंग मोर रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स दैन क्लैडिंग. एंड the outermost part, that is this buffer jacket or coating, is made up of, coating is made up of plastic, which provide a chemical resistance, which provide a chemical resistance from heat and some other substance which can damage the inner part. See, core is made up of silica, this cladding is also made up of silica or plastic, this coating and outer jacket is made up of polyamide, or you can say a kind of polymer, plastic polymer. Okay, then see acceptance angle, a new term, that is acceptance angle. What is that acceptance angle? We'll see. Acceptance angle is maximum angle that a light ray can have relative to that axis of fiber and propagate down the fiber. I hope you can understand by reading this definition, but to understand this definition, it will be more better to have a diagram. So this is a diagram for fiber optic cable. The inner part, see this lighter blue part, this is fiber core. The dark blue part is called fiber cladding, that is core and cladding. So if I send the light pulse through laser with this angle, this is axial line. If I send light pulse through this angle, the light will enter into this core and get reflect back in this way. So this is critical angle. So this is critical angle, angle of incidence, and this is critical angle. So this critical angle is playing a major role for the signal propagation. Okay, so it is an angle that light can travel relative to the axis of fiber. Get my point? What is acceptance angle? Similar to that acceptance angle, we have acceptance cone. So what is that acceptance cone? The light rays contains within a cone having full angle 2 theta, within angle 2 theta, are accepted and transmitted along the fiber. Therefore, the cone is called as acceptance cone. Now, how this cone is appearing? That appears like this. So this is our fiber optic core, this is outer part that is cladding, and we know this angle is critical angle. So if it can be seen in two dimensional, I can send light through this line, I can send light through this line, I can send light through this line. If I rotate this line along, it's a 3D path, so it will be kind of create a kind of cone through which I can send many light pulses at the same time. So this cone is called as acceptance cone. Get my point? What is acceptance cone? And last term related to this fiber optic cable is numerical aperture. So what is numerical aperture? Numerical aperture is nothing but the sine of acceptance angle. It's a formula is NA, numerical aperture, that is equal to sine of theta, or it is also written as NA, numerical aperture, equal to square root of n1 square minus n2 square. So what is this n1 and n2? N1 is refractive index of core and n2 is refractive index of cladding. So square root of refractive index of core square minus refractive index of cladding square, that will provide you numerical aperture. So in short, what is numerical aperture? Numerical aperture determine the light gathering ability. कितनी लाइट गैदर कर सकता है, उसकी एबिलिटी क्या है उस फाइबर ऑप्टिक की. मोर द न्यूमेरिकल अपर्चर, मोर लाइट सिग्नल्स और पल्सेस कैन बी अकोमोडेट और कैन बी एक्सेप्टेड थ्रू दैट फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल. सो न्यूमेरिकल अपर्चर प्लेज अ वाइटल रोल, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट रोल प्ले करता है न्यूमेरिकल अपर्चर. ओके, एंड हियर कम्स द idea of total internal reflection. Now see, I have sent the first light wave through this angle, so it will be transmitted in a straight line. So if I change the angle of incidence, there will be bending of light and it will travel in this way. The third signal is sent with a different angle of incidence that will travel through the axis of these two material, but when the angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, so this angle of incidence is less than critical angle, then this light wave will be reflected from the inner wall and light get reflect through this core only, and light will travel along this axis, and in this way total internal reflection phenomena will take place. Get my point? What is total internal reflection? Now after Africa, let's see which continent we should visit now. Let's go to Australia now. Now we'll see different types of fibers. Basically, fiber optics are divided into two different types, namely single mode fiber, it is also known as SMF, single mode fiber, and multi mode fiber. That is MMF, multi-mode fiber. So we'll see one by one what is single mode and what is multi-mode. Okay, let's see single mode fiber. Single mode step index fiber optic cable has a very small diameter of core. Now just try to remember, single mode fiber mein core ki jo diameter hai, the innermost part, the core diameter is very small, that allows only one mode of light to propagate through it. Cladding diameter must be at least 10 times than that of core. Now see, cladding, the next part to that core, the cladding diameter is about 10 times. How many times? 10 times than that of core, to avoid disturbance caused by small core. The refractive index of the in the fiber core is always greater than that of cladding. We have discussed the refractive index of core is always more is the cladding, the outermost part, and the innermost part is core. Now I will zoom this. Can you see a light pulse is sent through this core? So what is the problem with this? The diameter of this core is very small. उसका डायमीटर बहुत छोटा है. वेयर एज द डायमीटर ऑफ दिस क्लैडिंग शुड दैट ऑफ कोर, कोर के डायमीटर से 10 गुना ज़्यादा होना चाहिए टू अवॉइड reflection or the to avoid interference inside this pore cladding. So what is the problem with this single mode? In single mode fiber optic cable, only one light wave or one light pulse can be sent at a time. That means only one person can talk at a time, and it's a signal can be sent through it. So previously, before 10 years back, this single mode fiber optic cable has been used because there was no technology announcement till now. But after few years, scientists observed that we can send more and more light pulses. How? Through multi-mode fiber. Now we'll see multi-mode fiber. Yes, this is multi-mode fiber. So what is multi-mode fiber? Multi-mode step index fiber is an optic cable has a large diameter of core. Matlab, multi-mode fiber ka core ka diameter zyada bada hota hai as compared to single mode fiber, which allows multiple modes of light to propagate through it. So we can send many light pulses at the same time. So the optical modulator, this is an instrument name. So this optical modulator converts the electric signal to optical signals. Now when we say something at that time, our voice is get converted into electric pulses, and that electric pulses is get converted into waves, and those waves converted into signals, you know, optical signals, and that optical signal is sent through fiber optic cable, and that light pulses fiber optic cable signals has been sent over a large distance, and in this way communication can be done. So optical modulator is an instrument which is used to convert electric signals, whatever we speak, into optical signals or light pulses. So this is photograph of multi-mode fiber. Now see, the diameter of the core is being increased and the reduce. So here in this huge diameter core, we can send many pulse, or you can say this is this pulse represent the signal, represent the call of one person. So at a time one person can make a call and it's a signal get sent. The second person also call, but this signal has been sent through different angles. So green color light can be passed through it, and this is signal for second call. Similarly, the third call can be sent with a different acceptance angle. See this blue color or black color line, it is reflecting and moving ahead. So at a time we are sending three different signals through a single fiber, hence it is called as multi-mode fiber. So maybe possible you have observed such kind of problem during a special occasion like a new year. And when there is a new year, everybody want to wish their near and dear one a new year sharp at 12 o'clock. है ना, जैसे ही रात के 12 बजते हैं हम लोग क्या करते हैं, हमारे जो फ्रेंड्स रिलेटिव्स और जो है नियर एंड डियर वन, उनको हम लोग फ़ोन लगाकर हैप्पी न्यू ईयर विश करने की कोशिश करते हैं. बट प्रॉब्लम विद दिस इज़ दैट व्हेन एंटायर वर्ल्ड इज़ बिजी फॉर मेकिंग कॉल एट दैट टाइम देयर इज़ अ रिस्ट्रिक्शन. है ना, व्हेन मैनी मल्टी मोड फाइबर्स, ऐसे बहुत सारे, अब एक बड़े बंडल में, in a huge bundle there are, for example, say 100 multi-mode fibers. So in that 100 multi-mode fiber, this is one of them. So at the most, what PC will do, that system will try to send 3, 4, 10, 15, 100 signals, but it has some limit. So when the acceptance angle limit get over, then the system will not be able to put a condition to send signals. At that time you will be hearing a tone that the person you are calling is busy, but actually that person is not busy. The fiber optic acceptance angle is completely get filled. This line is busy, hence it is the signal that that person is busy. As soon as the, for example, 100 call signal, one call has been switched off, immediately your signal will be sent, and you immediately, within a fraction of a second, your call will be get connected through this multi-mode fiber. Nowadays everybody use multi-mode fiber for the communication because we can send many signals at the same time. single mode fibers is not being in use nowadays, because at the time only one light signal or one phone call can be sent through single mode fiber, but in multi mode fiber many signals can be sent at the same time. Now we'll move towards graded index fiber. Graded index fiber is also similar to the multi mode fiber. A graded index fiber is a multimode fiber. This is also similar to that of multimode fiber, with a core consisting of concentric layer of different refractive indexes. Now see, this is the multimode graded index fiber, where signals is not reflecting in a straight line. Now you will say, sir, aapne to kaha tha light is traveling in a straight line, but the construction of this graded index fiber is that the innermost part, that is this core refractive index of this core is varying at a different placements. That means at this place the refractive index of core is different, at this place refractive index is different, at this place diffractive index is different, at this place. Hence, instead of moving in a straight line, light takes a curve path and light is moving in this way. So it is not interfering in any way, but light take a concentric way to propagate through it. So this is also called multimode graded index fiber. Now see, what is the difference between two things? This is multimode graded index fiber diagram. I will show you again the multimode fiber optic diagram. Here the refractive index is uniform throughout the core. Pure core ka refractive index ek hai. Hence light is totally internally reflected in a straight line. Light is moving in a straight line. Whereas in graded index fiber, the refractive index of core at different places are different. Alag alag core ka alag alag refractive index hai. Hence light travel in a spiral path, slightly spiral path, bended way. So this is nothing but graded index fiber. Okay, so types of fiber in a nutshell, in a summary we can see this is step index multimode fiber, where the diameter of core is more, core ka diameter zyada hai, and the diameter of cladding is very small. So this is that light source through which light can be sent. See, we can send 1, 2, 3, 4 light pulses at the same time, but with the different angles they get totally reflected internally, and on the other side you will get 1, 2, 3, 4 different signals at the same time. This is multimode step index fiber. Whereas in graded index fiber is also multimode fiber, but the refractive index of this core is varying one. Hence light take a curve path like this instead of moving in a straight line, and at the end we get many light pulses. Whereas in single mode fiber, which is not in use nowadays, we can easily see the size or the diameter of this core is very small, and diameter of this cladding is huge one, that is of 10 times. At a time we can send only one light pulse or only one signal or only one phone call through this single mode fiber. Now that single mode fiber have also a kind of advantage. When this single mode fiber is used, single mode fiber can be used for defense purpose, where only one signal can be sent at a time. Bahut sare signal nahi bhejna chahte, at that time single mode fiber can be used. Okay, we'll see application part at the end. After Australia, let's go to Brazil and we'll see applications of fiber optic cable. So fiber optic cable can be used in medical field, because fiber optic cable is being used to study the interior part of a body like lungs or your intestine, where usually doctors cannot see externally. डॉक्टर बाहर से नहीं देख सकते हैं. सो इन दैट केस अ वेरी स्मॉल कैमरा कैन बी सेंड थ्रू दैट फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल. अ थिन, वेरी थिन फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल कैन बी सेंड थ्रू माउथ एंड द इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स, द कंडीशन ऑफ लंग्स और द कंडीशन ऑफ इंटेस्टाइन कैन बी सीन थ्रू दिस फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल. हाउ? इन दिस वे. अ ब्रोंकोस्कोप इज यूज्ड टू व्यू द एयरवेज, है ना. सी दिस डॉक्टर कैन बी सी द इंटीरियर पार्ट थ्रू दिस फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल. अ वेरी थिन फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल इज सेंड थ्रू दिस नोज, द नोज ऑफ अ पेशेंट. दैट फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल दैट इज गेट कनेक्टेड विद द कैमरा एंड दैट इज सेंड टू लंग्स सो दैट डॉक्टर कैन सी इफ देर इज एनी काइंड ऑफ इन्फेक्शन ड्यू टू सम वायरस और यू कैन से लंग कैंसर कैन बी ऑब्जर्व थ्रू दिस ब्रोंकोस्कोप. सो वॉट इज द अमाउंट ऑफ कैंसर बॉडीज दैट इज डेवलप इन साइड द लंग्स कैन बी सीन थ्रू दिस फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल. ओके. और यू कैन सी द कंडीशन ऑफ इंटेस्टाइन. सो इन दैट केस फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल हैज़ बीन सेंड थ्रू माउथ and that cable can see the interior part, is there any abnormality inside the intestine or not. The second application is a military application. As we have discussed, the military application is widely used for defense services because high privacy can be maintained while sending signals, because in defense system the privacy or the important instruction can be sent to only the concerned person. So in this way the Navy or Air Force or the other people, military people, can send signal to only the person who belongs to military only, and this can be possible with the help of fiber optic cable. So these are the connections that has been established through fiber optic cable. This antenna send signal to a specific satellite. Satellite will transmit signal to the spaceship or the huge ship or the aeroplanes. That signal has to be transmitted through this fiber optic cable. Now the next application in day-to-day life, that is telecom industry, isn't it? We use this fiber optic cable for the communication purpose, just like this, you know, you have seen such kind of cables around your home for the communication purpose, or you can say your internet provider, you know, wired internet provider, just like Hathaway or other things. And now TV or cable industry have changed their face through this fiber optic cable. Nowadays Jio Giga Fiber is being launched. The very I will tell you the very first thing, we are not here to promote anything. This video is not at all sponsored by Jio, but this is just for the example that nowadays many companies has been providing internet or cable TV through such kind of set-top box, where internet will provide you thousands of channel with a very good quality HD qualities video streaming through this kind of small setup. So fiber optic is changing the face of cable industry also. Now you will not need any kind of dish antenna which is to be placed on the terrace of your home. You just have to put this small set-top box around your TV, just connect a wire over here and you can enjoy the high definition quality of movies and cable channels through this fiber optic cable. Fiber optic cable is playing major role in sensors. Okay, it is used to measure temperature. Okay, fiber optic cable ke through hum log temperature, pressure, rotatory or linear position or liquid levels, we can send signal to measure all these things. Gyroscope measure rotatory motion, whereas hydrophones are used to measure acoustical disturbance under the water. So in this way, this fiber optic cable, a single fiber optic cable can sense, these sensors can send signal to other people where this interrogator is present. So that can sense acoustical vibration caused due to huge sound or intrusion. If there is some sort of a planning or digging, that digging on other things can also be sensed through this fiber optic. Or if there is a change of temperature, if there is a kind of fire, that fire can also be sensed and its signal can be sent to this sensor in the form of optical pulse. Okay. Now after Brazil, let's go to Canada, and now we are moving towards last part of our presentation, that is holography. many people have heard this holography because this is a very popular term nowadays, that is holography. So you have seen such kind of image, especially in the cartoon, and nowadays such kind of image has been there introduced in Hollywood movies also. So this is the picture of the famous Hollywood movie Iron Man, where this person is designing his Iron Man suit with the help of this holography. So holography is nothing but a kind of technique to reproduce a kind of image. So this holography is somehow similar to the sound recording. Okay, how it is similar, that we'll see. So what is holography? Holography is a technique that enables a wavefront, a light wavefront, to be recorded and later on reconstructed. फिर से बनाते हैं उसको. Holography is the best known as a method of generating three-dimensional images, but it is also had a wide range of other application. 3D image तो create करता ही है. Now see how this 3D image can be seen in many Hollywood or Bollywood movies. You can able to see how this 3D image can be created of a person, or 3D image of a brain can be seen through this holography. Now we'll see history of this holography. The Hungarian British physicist Sir Denis Gabor was awarded a Nobel Prize for the invention of this holographic method. So he was the person who have been awarded with the Nobel Prize for the invention of this holography in the year 1971. How to create a holograph? So holography is a technique that enables a light which is generally the result of light source scattered of object, and object se scattered hone wali light, to be recorded and later on reconstructed when the original light field is no longer present due to this absence of original object. Now see, it is somehow related to recording. And we have a tape recorder or CD and other things. So how it work? Holography can be thrown as somehow similar to the sound recording, whereas sound field created by vibrating matter like music instrument. And when somebody is playing a guitar, it means it is vibrating that vocal cord of that guitar, and sound is being produced. That sound is recorded on a CD or a tape recorder. That is recorded, and that recorded tape recorder or CD can be utilized to play sound through CD player, even though without the presence of original vibrating matter. When we play a CD in a CD player, at that time there is no guitar, but still that recorded sound can be played through CD. Similarly, a light is being captured through this holography, and that can be recreated after this. So this is holography. How laser holography work? In laser holography, the hologram is recorded using a source of laser light, which is very pure in its color and orderly in its composition. Various setup may be used for the laser holography. Now see how this laser holography is being created. A laser light beam has been sent in this way, a beam splitter, as its name suggests, beam splitter. What this beam splitter will do? Beam splitter will try to split the beam in this direction and one more beam in this direction. So as one of the light beam falls on this object, it will get reflect and recorded on this photographic plate. At the same time, a mirror is kept in a tilted angle. This another light wave will be reflected and sent on this. So this wave and this reflected wave, so this and this, these two light wave interfere each other, and they will produce a kind of 3D image on this photographic plate. And in this way, we can able to see the beautiful 3D image of any object. So this square block can be seen in 3D form. So this is related to laser holography. Now we'll move towards the last part of our chapter. I hope you understood all the things which we have discussed in our entire session. Now I request all the students to have a communication. If you have any doubt, you can ask question. I will say thank you at the end, but if you have do have any question related to this topic, you can put in your chat box. I can be answering those questions at the same time. So if you do have any problem, you can put it in your chat box. Acha, students, before saying thank you, I will request all the students who are attending this session that all the class teachers of these three divisions, Toksha sir or Rushi madam and me, we will send a link for attendance cum feedback form. So all the students are requested to fill that attendance cum feedback form and record your attendance for today's session. Okay, so if you do have any question, you can put your question in chat box. I am waiting for your question. So there are many students who are present, so you can put your question in chat box. If you do have any problem, you can ask. It's last 3 minutes to close our session. You can ask your query. Yes, Kedar Parker Paralkar have marking his attendance over here. Kedar, it is better to mark your attendance in a Google form, which will be sent through your class teacher. Yes, your attendance will be recorded after that. Don't worry. So I think there is no question from your side. There is no query from your side. I hope whatever things we have discussed today through this session, you understand all these things. Even though if you have any doubt or say if you have any query, you can ask in person through WhatsApp. I will be try to solve that query through WhatsApp or through any media. Thank you, students. That's all for today's session. Thank you for your gracious presence. Thank you, student. Thank you. We'll close today's session now. Thank you, students.